What's been going on?
Dorian's awfully pretty, isn't he?
What's been going on?
Not much. The usual. Nice of you to ask.
Take care.
Disaster is what it is, and you know it.
Theirs were not the only houses affected by the loss of heaven.
The land is only part. The girl has run off to the Inquisition.
A calling deeper than death to a name.
Even death must be pretty and fresh.
How odd that more men show up at the manor to speak with you. You and not I.
I apologize, sir. I've never met those men before.
And what did they need? Nothing uncivilly, I hope.
They asked about runes, something I found when I was a child. Rather strange for me.
Watch your tongue.
Maker.
Do you know where this noble wanted to meet us?
I do. The Comte Boisvert invited us to his mansion, not far from here. I pray he clears up the deaths of my messengers, as promised.
Lead the way.
Welcome, my friend.
Thank you for seeing us, Comte Boisvert.
The honor is mine. Please, sit. It's an honor to assist two such distinguished guests.
We appreciate your help, Comte.
The death of Lady Montilly's servants must weigh heavily on you. Have you heard of the House of Repose?
The Assassin's League?
My contacts obtained a copy of a document in the archives. Contract for life.
The House of Repose is hereby sworn to eliminate anyone attempting to overturn the Montilliers' trading exile in Orlais.
Overly complicated assassination plots are part of Orlesian politics, I take it.
They're all too common, I'm afraid.
The contract was signed by a noble family. The Du Parquets.
But the Du Parquets died out as a noble line over 60 years ago.
Indeed. But the contract was signed 109 years ago.
How can a family try to kill you after they died out?
The Du Parquets were our rivals. They drove the Montilliers from Val Royal. This contract was drawn up over 100 years ago, but it wasn't invoked until I tried to overturn my family's exile.
Unpleasant though it may be, the House of Repose is merely fulfilling its contractual duties.
If the people who wanted your family dead are gone, why are the assassins still after you?
A contract is a contract, Inquisitor. Orlesian businesses live and die by their reputations. The entire guild's welfare would be endangered if an agreement was tossed aside on a whim of time or fate.
She's quite right, Your Worship. The House of Repose is doing what it feels necessary by its standards.
I assume you have a thought or two on this, Josephine.
The Du Parquets still have descendants under the common branch. If we elevate them to nobility, a Du Parquet could annul the contract on my life.
That will take time, Lady Montigny. Time during which the House of Repose will be obliged to haunt you.
Will they now? You are not to have said you'd heard rumors.
Subterfuge. This contract on your life is an ugly business. One the House of Repose deeply regrets. But this is Orlais. Even an assassin's word is his bond.
Does Comte Boisvert actually exist?
Absolutely. The Comte's offer to reveal the killers of Lady Montilliers' messengers was genuine. So was his information, somehow. An end to be tied up later.
I thought you were remarkably well informed about a secret assassin's.
Just normally much more reclusive. The contract on Lady Montilliers' life is so unusual, we felt the courtesy of an explanation was in order.
It is appreciated, monsieur.
Your idea to seek out Du Parquet to revoke our orders is an interesting one. I wish you luck. I did not come to shed blood today, Inquisitor. Only to speak. Might I pass?
Go, then.
Good day, Your Worship. My lady, I pray we'd never meet again.
Well, I didn't think our meeting would end like this.
We'll deal with these assassins.
I have some thoughts. Let's discuss them back at Skyhold. I'll feel safer with the castle's walls around me.
Do you hear something?
Oh, goodness. Comte Poivert, is that you? Oh, the lock's been broken off. We'll find a saw. I realize the cabinet is quite valuable, Comte, but surely... A locksmith, then? As you wish. So complete. Mortals try to find the maker, that? And that becomes light. I'm so sorry, Inquisitor. I never thought my family's trading status would trap us in an assassin's plot.
You couldn't have known it would lead to this House of Repose coming after you.
It still shouldn't have slipped past me. I've tracked down the last du Paraquets. If they become gentry, they can annul the contract on my life. We'll require a noble from Val Royaux to sponsor them, a judge to provide documents, a minister to ratify them.
It's so like you to take the longest course of action, even when your life is at stake.
I assume you already know everything about this mess.
There is a faster way, Josephine. The original contract on your life is in the vaults of the House of Repose. If my agents infiltrate it and destroy the original, the assassin will have no obligation to chase you.
Liliana, please. I want no more bloodshed over a personal affair.
Don't be so stubborn, Josie. How long will it take you to gather these favors in Val Royaux?
Give me some time to think this over.
I'll post a watch on our ambassador in case the House of Repose visits.
I appreciate it, but I still believe elevating the du Paraquets will solve this. First, we need to perform some favors in Val Royaux. I'd be happy to discuss where we could begin.
Inquisitor, if you have a moment.
What is it?
Could prove. Thank you.
note. It claims this red lyrium is not coming from the deep roads. Another letter on the smugglers, referring to Samson.
Nothing to report, sir.
I notice you used a nullification enchantment combined with an offensive attack.
The nullification disrupts any ambient magic lying about. Things then burn hot.
Don't you then waste an inordinate amount of magic overcoming your own nullification?
Ah, no. I warp the veil slightly to affect distance between the spells.
Of course. Have you considered snapping the veil warp to enhance the relative energy?
Like cracking a whip? Yes, tried it once. Made my teeth taste funny.
We have to stop this mage. That it came to this, but at least it is done.
Word for you.
What is it?
Could prove useful, sir. Inquisitor, I've something for you.
What is it?
This could help us. My interest you, sir.
What is it?
It may be worthwhile.
Hmm.
one of the mages I spoke of. It's over. Thank you for bringing us here.
Word for you.
What is it?
Inquisitor, if you have a moment.
What is it?
See for yourself, sir.
rogue Templar. Sad that it came to this, but at least it is done.
Nothing to report, sir. This is one of the mages I spoke of. Sad that it came to this, but at least it is done.
Sarnia wasn't prepared for this.
Not to touch it or anything.
I wonder how far this corruption has spread. So, Seeker, your Inquisition grows.
It was never my Inquisition, Solas.
You did the brutal, thankless work of putting the wheels in motion. Do you feel no regret at letting that power pass to another?
I did my part, but the power you describe was never mine to carry. I know myself, and I cannot be the leader we need. Thus, I have no regrets.
You surprise me again, Seeker.
Your opinion of me must be very low for me to surprise you so often.
Not low, but realistic. Very few, however honorable, release power they have won.
Inquisitor.
How far will this lyrium spread? Red lyrium growths are warm.
I'd rather be cold than touch that stuff.
Now that they are allied with the Inquisition, the rebel mages are likely to enjoy more freedoms.
I expect you are correct.
I thought you would be pleased.
I will be pleased when the world we share is not threatened by a blight-corrupted madman. Regardless of who was responsible, the conflict between Templars and mages helped Corypheus rise to power. We cannot afford to let political infighting distract us from our duty.
Agreed. When it is done, I promise what you have done here will not be forgotten.
Thank you, Seeker. I think.
keeping watch.
Thank you.
kill them. Warrior!
What I like about you, Chuckles, your boundless optimism.
It's comforting that whatever qualities I lack, you'll invent for me, Varric.
No, really. Why else would an elven apostate help crazy chantry folk close a hole in the sky?
When you put it like that, I must concede your point.
News, Herald. Your efforts to drive off the Red Templars have not gone unnoticed. Imshael knows we're here. He sent Red Templars after me, and a pack of shades descends now upon Sarnia. The people are defenseless. I must return without delay. It's up to you to destroy Imshael.
Thank you.
need to do something about this.
Inquisitor. Huh?
really spend most of your time in the Fade?
As much as is possible. The Fade contains a wealth of knowledge for those who know where to look.
Sure, but I don't know how you dream, let alone wander around in there. Especially when the shit that comes out of the Fade generally seems pretty cranky.
So are humans. But we continue to interact with them. When we must.
Try not to touch that lyrium. What can I do for you, Inquisitor?
What are your thoughts?
If there's anybody out there who hasn't joined the Inquisition, they're hiding under a rock. Did you want to take over Ferelden? I think we might be able to conquer it just by looking east.
What do you think of Leliana's work?
Do you want to know what the Arashak had for breakfast this morning? I think she can tell you.
How do you think...
I'm starting to get the feeling that this is all a warm-up before she takes over Antiva in a bloodless coup.
What do you think of our general?
He's been insufferably smug lately. You might want to tell him to watch his back. I think Liliana might shiv him.
Good to know.
Back to work, then.
It's looking good. Not good enough, but good.
We stopped losing at
you did not notice? I had no idea Lady Beverly was one of your people. You might have told me before I embarrassed myself.
Work?
Inquisitor? What we have.
Where's my other hand?
Right there.
They've certainly spared no expense.
The smugglers we interrogated gave up the Red Templar's main source of Red Lyrium, Inquisitor. It's located in the Dales, near a town called Sarnia. Destroying the mine there will cripple Samson's operations.
Excellent work, Commander. I'll investigate the mine.
Destroying the Red Templar's source of Lyrium will be a loss Samson won't soon forget.
Gloat all you like. I have this one.
Are you sassing me, Commander? I didn't know you had it in you.
Why do I even... Inquisitor.
Leaving, are you? Does this mean I win?
Please don't stop on my account.
All right. Your move.
You need to come to terms with my inevitable victory. You'll feel much better.
Really? Because I just won, and I feel fine.
Don't get smug. There will be no living with you.
I should return to my duties as well, unless you would care for a game.
Prepare the board, Commander.
As a child, I played this with my sister. She would get this stuck-up grin whenever she won, which was all the time. My brother and I practiced together for weeks. Oh, the look on her face the day I finally won. Between serving the Templars and the Inquisition, I haven't seen them in years. I wonder if she still plays.
You have siblings?
Two sisters and a brother.
Where are they now?
They moved to South Reach after the Blight. I do not write to them as often as I should. Oh, it's my turn.
All right, let's see what you've got.
This may be the longest we've gone without discussing the Inquisition or related matters. To be honest, I appreciate the distraction.
You can't be serious all the time. Well, maybe you can.
I believe this one is yours. Well played.
It seems Blackwald knows nothing about the disappearance of the Grey Wardens. It's a disappointment. I am, however, glad that he is with us. Even if he was not what I expected. He seems to be a good man, and his experience will be an asset to the Inquisition. As for the other Wardens, I suppose we will have to keep looking.
Anything I should know?
I've agents stationed by the ruins of Haven, should Corypheus or his lackeys return. So far, nothing, and the breach has been quiet for some time. There is something, at least.
I'll leave you to your work.
So I take it you're Dalish? Is that the correct word here?
Yes, that's right.
We don't have Dalish clans coming northward, for obvious reasons. So I've never met one of your people before, although I've heard about them. Little. I hope this won't be an issue between us. I am here to help you deal with the Venatori, after all.
And I appreciate your help, Dorian.
Excellent. Mutual appreciation is a grand way to begin.
I should go.
You know where I'll be.
Hello.
What do you know about the Fade?
A great deal, from my wanderings. There are a few hard facts, but I can share what I have learned.
I'd like to know more about the Veil.
Circle mages call it a barrier between this world and the Fade. But according to my studies in ancient Elven lore, that is a vast oversimplification. Without it, imagine if spirits entered freely. The Fade was not a place one went, but a state of nature like the wind.
I don't know if I can imagine that.
Try. Imagine if spirits were not a rarity, but a part of our natural world. Like a fast-flowing river. Yes, it can drown careless children, but it can also carry a merchant's goods or grind a miller's flour. That is what the world could be if the Veil were not present. For better or worse.
We'll talk later.
Goodbye.
Good book?
I don't know what you're talking about.
Wait, are you blushing?
What would I have to blush about?
You tell me.
It's of no interest to you, I'm certain. It's a book.
I can see that.
It's one of Varric's tales. Swords and Shields, the latest chapter.
The latest chapter? Meaning you've read them all?
Not since this all began. We've been busy.
That's just her favorite.
Nobody asked you, Tevinter.
I couldn't finish the last one you lent me. I actually feel dumber for having tried.
It's literature. Smutty literature. Whatever you do, don't tell Varric.
Maybe I should read that book.
You? No!
Why not me?
You're the Inquisitor.
Oh, I see.
They're terrible. And magnificent. And this one ends in a cliffhanger. I know Varric is working on the next. He must be. You! You could ask him to finish it. Command him to... pretend you don't know this about me.
Stefan finally died. It was a blessing, really. He's been in so much pain since Haven. He was out of his mind at the end.
What can I do for you, Inquisitor?
Cassandra is waiting for the next issue of Swords and Shields.
I must have heard that wrong. It sounded like you just said that Cassandra read my books.
What's so surprising about that?
You have met Cassandra, haven't you? Wait, did you say the romance serial? Oh, she'll be waiting for a while then. I haven't finished it and wasn't planning to. That book is easily the worst I've ever written. The last issue barely sold enough to pay for the ink.
Well, Cassandra seems to be hooked on it.
And I honestly thought a hole in the sky was the weirdest thing that could happen. So, you want me to finish writing the latest issue of my worst serial for Cassandra? Oh, that's such a terrible idea. I have to do it. On one condition, I get to be there when you give her the book.
You've got a deal.
I'll get to work then. You know, the fact that the book is terrible just makes it more worthwhile somehow.
Inquisitor?
Heard you found something that had to do with Warden. Would have liked to have seen it.
I want to hear more.
Compared to yours, my life will seem dull indeed.
Your name, Blackwall, doesn't sound Orlesian. Marcher, then? Ferelden?
I was from the Free Marchers originally. Markham. That was a long time ago. Another life.
I hear that many wardens were once criminals.
You're right. And when you join, your past is forgotten, so let's leave it that way.
Why did you join the wardens?
Because they remember honor and sacrifice. Words that have little meaning to the rest of us. Because they lay down their lives for those they have sworn to protect. We all need to believe there are such men in the world. I needed to believe I could be one of them.
What did you do before you became a warden?
I was a soldier, a nobody trained to wield a sword and follow orders. I grew weary of fighting other men's wars.
So you became a warden?
More or less. Becoming a Grey Warden was the first time I felt like I mattered. The life I led before seems hollow in comparison. Perhaps one day it will fade away.
We can continue this discussion at another time.
Very well.
Feels good to be back at work, Inquisition. And lucky you have me. Mountain air like this, not healthy for many animals. But I'll make do with your little fortress.
Are your wife and daughter doing well?
Elena's minding the farms. Sienna's still running her full races. Wouldn't be fair to drag them up here. I miss them, but someone has to save the world.
How are your charges? Well supplied?
Surprisingly well. Not many could feed these people, let alone their mounts. Makes me wonder what you're capable of.
Heard anything worth noting?
Too busy to hear things, and that's how I like it.
Farewell.
Maker be with you.
Our mounts have never had better.
Let us begin. I must return to Valrayo to see that everything is in order. Please join me when you can.